In this video, I'm going to walk you through my process of writing clean code as a senior React developer. This process has basically been built over 8 years of experience, and hopefully it can help you write better code. And also, if you want to learn how to build a big and complex application with React as a total beginner, check out Project React in the description. So over here, we have a simple React application with a simple component, and we have here profile IDs, which is a static array of numbers. We have 1 all the way through 5. And then we're taking those IDs, we're mapping over each one of them, and then for every single one, we're rendering a simple anchor tag, and we're redirecting to /profile/ID. Now our task is to actually build out the profile page that this link is going to send to. And through that, I'm going to show you my process of approaching this and how I write clean code, and we're going to do it in very few lines of code. So the first thing that we're going to want to do is come here to our sidebar and create a new folder, because this is an empty project. We currently don't have a folder for all of our page components. So we're going to come here, make a new folder. We're going to call this one pages. And inside of it, we're going to make a new file, and we're going to do profile page.tsx like so. Create it and then open it. In here, we're going to do rjsfc for a shortcut. We're going to do profile page, and then we're just going to put a div over here. And now we're going to close this. What happened? There we go. Why is this always so much more difficult than I want it to be? And in here, we're going to put the content for our actual page. Now, I'm keeping things simple for the video. We don't actually have any routing solution set up to actually render this page on /profiles, but you can use your imagination. That's not the point of this video. The point of this video is to teach you how to build this component and the other components, and more importantly, how to approach building them. So the first thing that we're going to need in this component is probably some styles, right, for the general page. So we're going to come here and do class name, and we're going to do container, and then mx auto. What this is going to do is this container class here is going to set a max width for this entire div, and the mx auto is going to make sure that this is centered. Now the thing about these styles over here is I wouldn't put them directly inside of this profile page component, because the truth is, in reality, in a real project, you're most likely going to have other pages in your application, and they're most probably going to want to also have the same styles over here. These are more technically called layout styles than specific styles related only to the profile page. So instead of doing this, what I would actually do instead is I would come here to my sidebar, and I'll do a new folder here, because again, we don't have a folder for components. We're going to do components. And in here, I'm actually going to do a component, and we're going to call this one page layout.tsx like so. And in this component, we're going to put these exact styles. So let's close the sidebar. Let's come over here and let's take actually all of this, because this is going to be pretty much the same. Let's go back here to page layout, rename this to page layout. So page layout. And then we're going to have this component take in children as props. We're going to put these styles over here and then wrap the children with this div. That way we can use this for any page in our application and always get the same styles applied. So we're going to come here and we're going to do type page layout props, and that is going to be props with children, and we're going to import this directly from React. Let's keep things simple. We're not going to have any other props over here. And then we're going to do here children and then page layout props like so, and then we're going to pass these children directly inside of the div, children like so. Now we have the page layout component. We can come back here to the actual page, remove these styles because we're not going to need them, and then instead of this div, we can directly do page layout, import this from component /page layout, and then put our content over here. For example, we're going to put h1 profile page like so, and remove the space. Now we did the same exact thing as we had it before, but we've extracted all of the layout styles inside of a separate component, and we can actually use that component in here in the profile page and any other page that we have in our application. This is also really useful in the case where you might want to add different things to this page layout. For example, in a lot of cases, you're going to have a navbar component over here. And if we save, we might also have a footer over here as well, right? These would go inside of the page layout because you don't want to have to import and put all of these components in every single page. Even worse, if you want to change how these are displayed, maybe this gets a wrapper div or something with some styles, you can put them once inside of this component, and then every page that uses this component automatically gets the same exact styles. This makes it much more cleaner, and it's much more scalable to do it this way. Now, here's the thing. What we're currently doing right now inside of this video is something called learning by doing, right? I'm not just telling you and showing you theory and just boring you with that. I'm actually showing you how it's done. And more importantly, I'm helping you understand why we do it this way instead of another way. And that's great, because that is also what the sponsor of today's video, Brilliant, also does. So Brilliant is a place where you learn by doing, with thousands of interactive lessons in various topics such as math, data analytics, AI, and more importantly for us, programming. Brilliant has a learning platform that is designed to be uniquely effective. Each lesson on there has you solve problems using a hands-on approach that lets you play and get a feel for different concepts, which actually has been proven to be a method 6 times more effective than just watching simple lecture videos. Plus, all of the content on Brilliant is crafted by an award-winning team of researchers and professionals from places like MIT, Microsoft, Google, and more. The great thing about Brilliant is that it really helps you build critical thinking skills through problem solving and not memorizing. So while you're building real knowledge on specific topics, you're also learning how to be a better thinker. And it helps you do all of that in just a couple of minutes a day with really fun lessons that you can do whenever you have the time. It's really the opposite of mindless scrolling, and it really builds a great habit. They actually have some great courses such as Thinking in Code, which follows what we're doing in this video and teaches you solid foundations for computer science, which will help you actually become a better React developer. To try everything that Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/causesandsolutions or click the first link in the description. You're also going to get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Thank you once again to Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and now let's continue learning about clean React code. So now we have the profile page. This profile page is going to receive an ID. So we're going to come here, we're going to do type profile page props. That is going to be a simple object with profile ID, and that is going to be number. Let's assume that this ID somehow gets passed through our navigation solution, which again, we don't have on setup, user imagination. Here we're gonna do profile ID, and we're gonna do profile page props. Now we're gonna wanna use this ID to actually fetch the data of that profile, because the ID obviously isn't enough. And then we're gonna wanna display the data inside of this component. So to do that, we might do something like this, const and then profile data. Set profile data and then use state. We're going to define this to undefined for now. And then depending on how you do this, you might use React Query, you might use something else. We're just going to do it in a simple use effect because it's sufficient for this video. We're going to do use effect, and then we're going to call this a function. We're going to give this a dependency array, which is going to be profile ID. And inside of here, we're just going to do const fetch profile, profile equals async function, and then here we're going to do await and then fetch slash API slash profiles, and then we're going to pass your profile ID like so, and then we're going to need the response. So const response equals await, then const data equals await, and then response.json, and finally we're going to do set profile data, and we're going to do profile actually data and set the data inside of our state. And finally, we're gonna call fetch profile, and we're gonna fetch profile, and we're gonna call this function directly inside of the use effect. So now again, this is a very simple example, but essentially you have some code that is going to fetch the data based on this ID, and then is going to set it in some state. Now this is all well and good, and this will work. This is going to fetch the data, and then obviously it's not handling loading and error states, which again, it's fine. It's going to set the data inside of profile data, and then we can use it directly in this component. But again, I wouldn't do it this way. This is not clean code. The thing is, this code shouldn't belong inside of a page component. A page component, its only responsibility is to take all the different pieces of code and things that are available across the application, put them together, and actually build what it is to actually be the profile page. It's not responsible for actually implementing the details of those specific things. Like this fetching, for example, it should just pull something that fetches the data instead of implementing the data fetch itself, if you get what I mean. So instead, what I would do is I would come here to my sidebar and I would create a new folder inside of SRC, and we're going to call this one hooks like so. Inside of here, we're going to create a new file. We're going to do use fetch profile.ts. We're going to close this, open up use fetch profile. In here, I'm going to export one simple function, export function use fetch profile. And this one is going to take profile ID, which is going to be of type number. And in here, we're going to put the same exact code as we had over here. We're going to take all of this code here, and we're going to put it directly inside of use fetch profile, which is a custom hook. We're going to come here, import use state. We're going to come here and we're going to import use effect. And finally, we're going to return profile data like so. The benefit of doing it this way is that now we've extracted all of the logic of actually fetching a specific profile based on the profile ID in a separate component. This makes it reusable. It makes any component that actually needs to fetch the profile just have to import this use fetch profile hook. And it also removes the responsibility of profile page to actually implement the details, the actual implementation of fetching a user's profile. And then going back to profile page, the only thing that we have to do is we just have to do const profile data. equals use fetch profile, import this from at hook slash profile, and then pass it profile ID like so. And now we have the same functionality, we have the same profile data, but again, we're using this custom hook, which makes our code a lot cleaner. Right, so whenever you're thinking about adding some functionality to a component, always ask yourself first, does this component have the responsibility of actually implementing that functionality, or does it belong somewhere else and we just have to import that component or that custom hook instead? Right, and then you make your decision based off of that. So now we have profile data over here, we're actually gonna wanna do something with profile data. Let's say we wanna actually use it here, profile data, and profile data contains some things that we wanna put inside of this component. Again, I wouldn't do it this way because once again, it's not the responsibility of profile page to actually have the code that implements the UI of the profile data. Instead, what I would do once again is I would come here inside of components and I would create a new file and I would call this one profile data.tsx like so, and put all of that logic inside of a separate file, inside of a separate component. So here we're gonna do rjsfc, we're gonna do profile data, and then we're gonna return for now empty. You can just, let's see what happened. You can just imagine that this will do something cool with profile data, right? And then here we're just gonna have this type profile data props, and that is going to be an object and it's going to return data. And we're just gonna put any for now because we actually don't have any types, it doesn't really matter. We're gonna do here this and we're gonna put profile data props like so. Now we have a separate component called profile data, which takes in data over here, which can be used to actually do something cool with profile data and actually show the UI of the profile data. Then once again, we're gonna come back here to profile page and instead of putting profile data like this, we're gonna remove it and we're gonna do profile data, import this from component slash profile data, and we're gonna pass data over here as profile data like so and close this component. Now we did the same exact thing as we did here with this custom hook, but we did it with a custom component. Instead of having the profile page be responsible for implementing the logic of displaying profile data, we can actually create a separate component, pass it the profile data and have that work that way. The reason why you want to do things this way whenever you're building React applications is that now look at profile page and how small it is, right? And we actually have a lot of functionality here. We're fetching data directly, so we have a whole fetch system that is part of this component that we just have with one line of code. Then we actually have layout and styles. We actually have, if I remind you over here, we have a navbar, we have a footer directly inside of this profile page over here, and we actually have the UI that displays the profile data. All with that, with like 10 lines of code, 9 lines of code actually. This is how you write clean code in React. And then profile data over here, you can imagine that this component would also make use of other components. For example, let's say that we had a part of it that was the something like the avatar component, right? So we're gonna do avatar and close it like this. You can imagine that this would hold the actual profile picture of that specific profile and might have some functionality to allow the user to actually edit their own profile. Might have a button that when you tap on it, it's gonna pull up a file input or something and then allow you to edit the profile. You would put all of that in a separate component and not inside of profile data over here. You would just pass the avatar whatever you need to pass it. For example, I don't know, we can do like profile photo equals and then profile data dot profile photo. Photo like this, right? So now this component will have one responsibility. It's going to have the actual functionality to display the avatar and any other functions related to it. And we pass it from here any properties that it needs to do its functions. If we then had another component, for example, the profile posts, we can have something like post list, right? Which is a list of posts. And we can actually do something like posts. And then we're gonna do profile data dot post like so, and pass the actual post of the profile data to post list. Post list would then take those posts, would actually render them, would probably defer the rendering of each specific individual post to another component. And doing it that way, you build really clean code in React and you build applications that can scale really, really well. And then as you do this, you're eventually going to get to a point where you're rendering actual UI. And that's where you're going to use UI components. So things like buttons, inputs, text, cards, and so on, you're going to use those to actually render what is being shown on the screen. But as you can see, those components usually don't go directly inside of a page component. We're never going to see an actual UI component over here. I mean, yes, we have an H1 tag, but we could directly put this inside of profile data as well. It's completely up to us. But usually you're not going to see individual UI inside of this component. You're going to see them either in a feature component, which is this profile data, which actually handles the feature of displaying a profile data, or in other subcomponents. Like you could expect to see some UI components inside of the avatar component, like an actual thing that renders an actual image with the user's profile photo. That will go inside of this avatar component. If you do it this way, and if you build a habit of splitting things up into smaller components or custom hooks every single time, you're never going to build really big components that are super messy, and you're always going to write clean code by default. It's going to be a great habit for you to learn. And some of you might say that this might be overkill. Like, why are we creating a whole custom hook just to fetch this one user profile? And the thing is, it might seem like overkill, but it's really not, because the moment that you need to use this hook in a separate place, you're already going to have it created in a separate file instead of taking the exact code that you had here and duplicating it inside of two components. That is worse to do, and you're much more likely to do that if you don't already have a custom hook that is already created and reusable for you to use. So really, the way that I write clean code in React is I always follow this approach. I split everything up into different types of components. So page components, which have the responsibility once again to take everything across the application and put them together and make up what it means to be the actual page that is trying to render. And then we have feature components, which go inside of page components usually, that handle individual features, and those might use other feature components or directly might use UI components to actually render out some UI. It's really not that complicated. Actually, what is complicated to me, as ironic as that sound, is to actually write complicated code. I don't get how people write complicated code when if you follow a simple pattern of actually delegating and creating custom components, you're just never going to end up writing any complex code ever, and most of your components are going to look like this. So there you go. These are some simple tips and tricks that I use on a daily basis to always make sure that I write clean code in React. I hope that you enjoy this, and I hope that this has now made you a better React developer. And once again, thank you to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos just like this one, make sure to leave this video a big thumbs up. You can also click here to subscribe, or you can click here to watch a different video of mine that YouTube seems to think that you're really going to enjoy. And with that being said, my name has been Darius Kosden. This is Kosden Solutions. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Ciao, ciao.